Welcome, my Action Principles champions. I'm Bill Fitzpatrick, founder of the American Success Institute, and honored to be your teacher on your wonderful life journey to success. Action principle number 7, commit to never-ending improvement. When we speak of being an Action Principles champion, well, we immediately think of our big goal, to be rich and retired in 20 years or less. Now, this is going to happen because of what you're willing to do today, what you're willing to do tomorrow, what you're willing to do the day after tomorrow, and next week, and next month, and in the coming years. Success is not automatic. It's a cumulative process of continuing improving and building. We build one brick at a time. We take one step, followed by the next step. Success is consistently making the right choices. Now, as soon as I say success is not automatic, it comes into my mind, well, you know, it kind of is automatic. You see, success is the result of cumulative achievements. Success is the result of all those good habits that you perform day after day after day. Success is who you are right now. Right now, you can choose to live as a successful person. You live as an Action Principles champion. An Action Principles champion, well, you're someone who's tough, who's thoughtful, who is a spiritual person of action. You get up every morning enthused and focused on what you have to accomplish for that particular day. During the day, you find an opportunity to take your 20 minutes of quiet time. In that quiet time, you can reflect, adjust. Where have I been? Where am I now? Where am I going? You take measure of yourself. And it stops you from being, well, you see so many average people, and what are they doing? They're living the same boring day over and over again. Is it Monday? Is it Thursday? Is it morning? Is it afternoon? Is it June or October? Hey, whatever. You see, you're an Action Principles champion. You're not thinking, hey, whatever. You are the opposite of whatever. See, you have specific dreams, goals, objectives, and to-dos. You got a lot of stuff that you're excited about accomplishing. You have a direction for your life, and you move in that direction just a little bit better all the time. A little bit better all the time. You're building your career. If you're an entrepreneur, you're building your business. All right, a couple of examples. Let's say, for example, that you work in a department store. You're a cashier. Well, you're a cashier, but you're learning what it takes to become the head cashier. Then when you're the head cashier, then you're focused and thinking about, well, I'm going to be the front of the store assistant manager. When you have that job, then you're thinking about being the merchandising manager. Then the general manager. You're always looking ahead. Where is the next step? What do I have to do? What's the research? Who's doing what it is that I want to do? What can I learn from them? The other cashiers are, well, they might be perfectly happy to remain as cashiers. You're an Action Principles champion. You're a success-oriented person. You aren't content. Maybe along the way, you invest your time and your money, and you get a bachelor's degree in business at night. Then maybe when you have that, then you move on and you get a master's degree. How do people progress? You find out what you have to do, and then you do what you have to do. You learn what has to be done to reach the next level, and then you do what you know you should be doing. What did we say? We said One of our experts. Don't complicate matters. Let's take a slightly different example. Let's say that you're a hairdresser. And there are peaks and valleys in all of your days. Client doesn't show up. Now, a lot of the other hairdressers, when they have free time, and a lot of hairdressers, if you talk to them, they have a lot of free time during the day. What are they doing? Well, they're sitting around, they're gossiping, they're reading the tabloids. Okay. I mean, generally, they're wasting this free time. This could be hours in a day. You're an action principles champion. You don't want to waste this time. You want to invest this time. I mean, maybe you go to a nursing home. It's hard for the people in the nursing home to get down to the salon, so you go to them. You find some business there. Maybe because you're doing this and you have a senior citizen's discount and you're doing, maybe what you're doing becomes a human interest story and the newspaper writes an article about you. Well, how do these things happen? They happen to people who are out in the game doing these things. Maybe in the morning when you're at the coffee shop, you find an opportunity to hand a new person one of your business cards with the offer, and you can write this right on the back, free haircut. What did I say? The free haircut, But you see, maybe that person who gets that free haircut, and you get a free haircut, and you do a, what are you going to do? A quality product? You're going to do a great job. Maybe that person who gets that free haircut becomes a regular client of yours for as long as you're going to be working, which is, maybe for the next 20 years. How much is one new regular customer worth to a hairdresser? Probably thousands of dollars. Potentially thousands of dollars are made from that person who took the initiative to give the free haircut. Probably that one person getting that free haircut is going to be so astounded by this wonderful offer that they're going to tell their mother, father, sister, brother, neighbors, friends, coworkers about you from that one free haircut. Investing wasted time, you start building buzz for yourself as a hairdresser. What were the other hairdressers doing? Well, they're probably reading, some dog-eared version of some tabloid newspaper or magazine in the salon. You are an action principles-oriented hairdresser. Probably if you actually do this, you're going to have so many customers, your schedule calendar is going to be so filled. Well, this is business. This is supply and demand. What happens when demand exceeds supply? Well, prices go up. There's nothing wrong with this. You start charging a little more than the other hairdresser. Why? Because, you're in demand. Take the next step. You're going to be making more money as an action principles hairdresser than an average hairdresser. Now, what do you do with this extra money? Well, you're an action principles champion, so you use some of this money to invest. And in a cumulative way, never-ending improvement, you say, how do self-made rich people get rich? You've kind of figured this out. Keep improving. Making money. Taking some of that money and investing. Keep learning. What do I have to do next? Here I am. Where's the next level? What's the next step? Who has the next job that I want? How did they get there? What are they doing? What qualifications do I need? Do I got to go back to school or get more training? What do I have to do? You will actually like the idea of challenging yourself. You will constantly set new goals for yourself, and you will use your action principles to divide and conquer, committing yourself to never-ending improvement.